Hello again. We're in the home straight of our wire removal series. We've split up the removal process over the past few hours and created multiple small sections. Now's the time to bring this all together. Is this straightforward? Generally, yes, but there are a few traps along the way. I'll switch over to silhouette now and we can see which ones we can avoid. All right, welcome back. We are moving forward with this shot. And in fact, we've got five different elements now to start to put together. So we have the shoulder over on the top left. There we go. We have the wire remove on the bottom left when it goes over the body. Excellent. We have the top wire remove, which is the main one up there. And we have the bottom right, which is over the body when it goes over here. And finally, the off body wires. So where they're over underneath the hair. Let's turn those on. Hang on a sec. I think I may have turned off some of the roto layers. I did turn off the roto layers. Let's turn those back on. That's going to look better, isn't it? Get back up. There we go. So we've got our wires when they're going off body. Excellent. So now let's start putting these all together. What we've done up till now is we've composited all of these against the original. Pretty much what we have to do is just get these into a rough order and then start building these on top of each other. And that should work out fine and give us an idea of what is left to do on this shot. Okay, so this is what our tree looks like when it's been taken apart. And now it's up to us to put all of these things back together. Now, I want to have everything flowing between these different sections, of course. And at the moment, we're compositing back to the original each time, which is how we've managed to do it up till now, just so we could focus on one individual area. There's only a couple of rules that we need to enforce when we're doing this. And one of these is purely sort of creative. So we want to have the bits that build on top of each other sort of put together. So that means that the wire remove on the bottom left, which is filling in this little area here, I want to have that underneath the shoulder. So we're going to composite the shoulder on top of the wire bottom. So that's one thing that I know we need to do from just a purely creative point of view. So I can just bring that in there and replace the original. The other thing that we need to watch out for is circular references. So we can't have the off-body wires compositing in over the top of themselves because it just creates this sort of loop. So we need to have the off-body wires after the top wire removal, which is fine. So if we have the flow going a little bit like this, we have wire bottom left, the first one. So that's coming in with the original, going out, great. Going into the shoulders, which is what we've got here. Excellent. We'll close that up. Then we can have the shoulders going into the bottom remove here, which is fine. So let's take the shoulders, alt click on my little dot to bring that in and replace where the original was going. We'll rearrange these in a second. And then the final thing is to have the output from this one going into the top wire there. So let's bring this over there. So this should be working so far. And it is, everything is kind of moving through. Now just the final one. Can I composite this into here? So let's now composite the top wire removes into here because this should work fine because both of these are coming from the same area. So we've got one transform going in there with the paint and the roto and the other one coming through with the composite, and that should work out nicely. And it does. Look at that. That's starting to really come together. That's looking nice. Okay, so with the layout done, let's bring this here. Let's just get this looking like just a little bit nicer again. And one of the things that we can do with Silhouette 2021 is change how these are ordered. So at the moment, if we look at the nodes and look at the options, all of the connections are set to curved and all of the layout is set to the default. And I've got my default set to vertical. So I can set all of these to horizontal and all of these to straight. Let's actually select everything. And I want to go into the bottom one here as well and set this one to vertical but straight. And that should give me what I need. There we go. And then through the miracle of editing, we have something that looks a little bit more sensible. Still keeping my tracker there. There we go. And my Mocha work in progress. We've got boom, 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 boom. So I understand where everything is in the process a little bit more. So with this laid out in a bit of a nicer way, let's preview what we've got. And here's where we are. And do you know what? We're not looking too bad. There's a few bits. Let's just play this back and you'll be able to see them straight away. There's a few bits we need to change up. This bit on the side here. And I think all we need to do with this one is to extend out where we've got the bottom left remove. Just extend that out a few frames. And then that should work really nicely when it goes over to the place where we've done all the hair. So that should work out really well. And on the opposite side, that also pops a little bit. You see that popping on? That's not great. So we need to find a way to smooth that over. And I think we're going to do a bit of paint work on that. So that shouldn't be too big an issue, but now we can see we've got a little problem there. And the other thing to do, apart from the right hand shoulder, which is still a bit of an issue, but the biggest issue is obviously going to be the face at the start. So that's tricky. We could try to do it with the power mesh like we've done before, but we might have to just do it with a more straightforward painting. Just regular clone paintwork. Well, now we have a better idea about what we've done and what is missing. In the next part, we'll focus on how to get a consistent result on the face and why these few frames are actually some of the trickiest to do in the whole shot. So I'll see you over in exercise 14.